So as you guys may know, the RTX 3000 cards are going to drop pretty soon, with the 3080 being the first on the 17th of September. And Bitwig, aka Carl, has come up with a theoretical build for the 3070. So taking a leaf out of his book, we decided to come up with our own speculative builds for the 3070 and 3080. We are not here to go up against Carl, but create options for you guys, especially those living in our region in Singapore as well as Southeast Asia. Okay, so there are a few disclaimers first. Number one, even though the prices for the cards are out, they are definitely in the USD and they are not SGD. So pertaining to that, PC parts in Singapore tend to be more expensive than those in Europe. So make sure to take note of that before you start raging on prices or comments like, why is everything so expensive? Why is everything so expensive? Yeah. Do negative on that first.
Yeah, please keep the flame throwing to a minimum. Yeah. Just putting out fires is not fun.
So the next point that you need to know is that wattage for the cards are not out yet. So the power requirements as well as the PSU chosen would have been changed when the wattage for the cards are out once the cards are launched. So yes, if you'd like to see this cards actually come alive, make sure to subscribe to our channel, click on the bell to see when we actually build up this new build. So without further ado, let's carry on with this theoretical builds.
Okay, right. Thanks, Mel. Now, the one for the RTX 3070, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to use our own Typhoon Systems website configurator, and we're going to extrapolate a config based on that. For the 3070 config, we're going to try and keep it below SGD $2,000, or in Freedom Money, that will be about 1.4K USD. As for the 3080 config, we've decided to go for somewhere around in the region of SGD $3,000, or in USD, we're looking at about 2.1-2.2K USD. So, based on that, let's get started on it, and I'll take you through based on my website. Okay, alright, now I'm in my configuration page for my Roku mid-range PC model. Now, as you can see, the base config I have here starts off at 120. Okay, now it's 1270, because we're feeling generous this month. Right, so let's get down to it. Okay, so first off, if I'm saying no, I don't really want any RGB, that kind of thing. I just want fast and cheap. Right, we'll cater right to that. So the $30 discount is for you. The next stop we're going to have here is the CPU itself. So this is one part where we are going to diverge a bit from Bitwig recommendation, where he tried to squeeze it down to USD $1,000 by using the 36. It is not my place to agree or to disagree with him, but in this case, what I feel is that if you're going to put something like as powerful as the 3070, especially if it is as powerful as they say it is, what I would probably recommend is probably to put something with 6 core 12 threads, but with a little bit more oomph in each of the 6 cores itself. So rather than we go with the 3600, we'll go with the 3600 XT. So that means you get higher boost clocks, that kind of thing, to more in sync with the theoretical performance of the 3070. Next, we come down to the cooler itself. Now, in this case, I have never really been a big fan of the AMD Wraith Spire for Ryzen 3rd Gen, especially if you're talking about the fact that it comes with the 3600 XT. It's just not quite there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to, for SGD $65, I'm just going to add in the Cryogic H7 120mm air cooler, which will allow my 3600 XT to be able to boost to higher clocks. Next, we come down to the motherboard itself. Now, my Roku starts off with a B450M Pro VDH Max from MSI. Now, this is a rather cheap and cheerful motherboard. It's not too fancy, that kind of thing. But my take on this is this. If you're going to have a 3070, you will want to start off with a B550. And not only do you want to start off with a B550, you probably want to start off with a good one. So what I'm going to do here is that rather than take a B450 and maybe add the Wi-Fi later, because one thing here in Singapore is that the majority of our customers here do pick Wi-Fi with their sets. So rather than pick a B450 and add a Wi-Fi card, what we're gonna do here is that we are going to select the B550M Mortar Wi-Fi, which already comes with our Wi-Fi 6, as we have featured in a previous video. So as you can see, if you come down here, yeah, the Wi-Fi options are gone. Because why? This motherboard has onboard Wi-Fi 6 plus Bluetooth 5.1, or was it 5.2? Yeah. So yeah, based on that, you already have a B550 motherboard with good VRM heatsink, good set of features, as well as onboard Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. Next, we come down to the RAM itself. So we're going to start off with 16 gigs of 3200MHz CL16 RAM. So for the RAM itself, while we don't put the brand down here, usually what we like to use is G-Skill Flare X set of RAMs. They have no RGB, but they have decent heat sinks. They have decent timing, so we'll go with them. And we've had no issues with them on all the Ryzen builds that we do. So right, Next, we go to the primary storage itself. Okay, now here is the part where it's a bit of a point of contention. Some people may say, hey, you know what? Just any SSD will do. I want to save some money. So, right, that's nothing wrong with that. You can go with a 500GB NVMe SSD. Or if you feel like you want 1TB of super fast storage, you can go with the Corsair MP600 1TB. But this is going to add an additional $350 more. If you're a content creator, yes, I'll say go for the Corsair MP600. You'll want the read-write access speed. But if you are looking for, let's say, just SSD storage, we'll just stick with the 500 and we'll just call it a day. So moving right downwards, so we have storage secondary. So to complement our 500GB SSD, maybe we'll put a 2TB hard disk drive. Power supply will stick with a 650W 80 plus bronze, since Nvidia did put down there that the RTX 3070 will chug along just fine on the 650W power supply. Now, I don't really like to skirt along the edge of specifications. That means if Nvidia says 650, I don't really like to put down there 650 because Nvidia says it's 650. So in a situation like this, normally I like to put a 750W power supply, but we'll see when the actual 3070 comes here. So this is one part that is fuel for speculations. So right now we come down to here and we are now up to 1670. So you may be wondering, I have not changed the GPU as of yet. So right now, what I have is I've taken the base option, the RTX 2060. Since I don't quite have an equivalent here to match up with what the 3070 theoretical pricing here, this is where I'm going to go a little bit manual. So we have 1670 so far. So in Singapore, an RTX 2070, which I predict is going to be the launch price of, let's say, entry-level RTX 3070, something with no bling, that kind of thing. So the price difference between an RTX 2070 Super and an RTX 2060 here in Singapore is about SGD 300, give or take 10 or 20 bucks. Let's plus 300 here. So yeah, we have 1970. So I brought aside the calculator. So what we have down here for 1970 is that we have a 3600 XT, 120mm air cooler. We have a decent mid to high end B550M mortar Wi-Fi. We have 16 gigs of RAM. We have a 500GB NVMe SSD, 2TB hard disk drive, a 650W 80 plus bronze power supply. We have not included in the Windows license because some of our customers, they prefer to get the license on their own, or they have other ways of getting it. Right, so if you've got a little bit of budget to spare, so we have 1970. So let's get into what you will probably come in useful, especially in this day and age. You will want a decent keyboard and mouse. Would I be right to say so? So let's go with the MSI Vega GK30 combo. So what it looks like? It looks like this. So this is what was featured in our previous video, the B550 Gaming Pro Carbon Wi-Fi video. That keyboard and mouse was featured in that. So yes, if you bundle it, you will get this keyboard for SGD $99. Going on to that, if you're going with the GK30, yeah, that's one option. Or if you feel that, you know what, I think maybe a normal wireless mouse and keyboard is enough for me, so you can take this as well. So it's up to you. Next, we come down to the one thing that's very important in this day and age, a webcam. So we have the AVerMedia Livestream Webcam 313, which is actually this fellow over here. It is a decent 1080p webcam with its own built-in mic. It's got this nice little slider down here so that when you're not using the webcam, you can just slide the lens shut. It's a good thing to have. We'll bundle it in. So let's add this in manually into our calculator. Plus 99 for the MSI keyboard and mouse combo, plus 99 for the webcam. So we have 2168 SGD. It's a little bit over our budget, but yeah. It's a more complete solution. You get a set, you get a keyboard, you get a mouse, and you get a webcam all in one shot. The only thing that you're missing is a monitor. That one you can sort out. One more thing though, yeah, if you're looking under software itself, we have Office 2019. So you may be wondering, what is this thing called Capture One Pro? So Capture One Pro is a photo editing software somewhat akin to, like, let's say Adobe Photoshop and Adobe Lightroom and all that. This is the website for you to take a look. If you want to check out more details, check out in the link in the description below. One thing about this software, it's kind of very able to make use of all the hardware that you've put in, like, let's say what we've just built up, like the GPU as well as the CPU. But the one thing that you probably appreciate about this software is that the one that we bundled here is the perpetual version. So if you're sick and tired of donating your monthly charges to the Church of Adobe, this is something to consider. So right, so that concludes our little RTX 3070 theoretical build. So let's get on to the next build, which is the RTX 3080 build for under SGD 3K. So let's get right on to that. Now that we've done with the RTX 3070 build, now we'll go on to the big fella, the RTX 3080 theoretical build. So for the purpose of this demonstration, I've pulled up our Typhoon Systems website again. This time I'm pulling up my Hachi configuration right over here. So we're gonna start off with an AMD Ryzen 7 3700X. So following the 3700X, so for this little exercise, we're going to stick with the stock cooler because the Rave Prism is an excellent cooler, so we'll stick with that. So for the main board, because we are going to put in a 3080, so of course we want something with PCIe 4. So we're going to go with the MSI B550 Gaming Carbon Wi-Fi. So you can check out in the link below the video that we did on this particular motherboard itself. Move right along, we have 16 gigs of 3200 CL16 RAM, so 2x8 gig. Then next, we come down to the GPU. Now, this is where things are a little bit easier for me, because what my prediction is that the RTX 3080, when they land here, they will float more or less at around the same pricing that the 2060 Super currently now occupy. So I'm just going to leave the 2080 Super here as a sort of like a placeholder. Then we come down to the storage itself. So we have 1TB PCIe 4 Gen 4 NVMe SSDs. For this, what we usually go with is the Corsair MP600 1TB. So we have no secondary storage, so we're just going to use that 1TB PCIe 4 NVMe SSDs. Power supply, because we know the 3080 is going to be a power hungry SOB. Based on that, we're going to stick with the 750W 80 Plus Go PSU right over here. Next, we come down, so we're not going to add in Windows, again for the same reason that we didn't add it in for the Roku, because we assume you're probably going to get it yourself. So now the theoretical cost that I have here is SGD 2950. So we've just bring it right under Singapore 3K or US 2100. So right, so maybe you're feeling a little bit generous today, but then you take a look at the little picture on the screen down here. Hey, what if I want my set to look as colorful as this? Well, if you want that, and you also bring some performance benefits as well, is that instead of the Rave Prism cooler, what we're going to do is we're going to select down here and we're going to go all out with the EK240mm AIO. So right, I also want colorful RAM. Alright, we can do that for you. So we have the Trident Z Neo. So let's go with that. I mean, if we're going to play 3080, let's go with fast RAM to go along with it. So based on the mathematics I have here, so we have brought ourselves down to 3.2K SGD, or in USD, we're looking at about, slightly under US 2.3K. So if you look at it this way, for US 2.3K or Singapore 3.2K, go through the configurator again, we have a 3700X, a 240mm AIO, and a pretty good one, I may add, which is this one right over here. Do take note the price here is in USD, so it's 119 USD. In Singapore, it's probably floats in the region of about 170 SGD, 180 SGD. Then we have the B550 Gaming Carbon Wi-Fi, one of the best B550 motherboards you can have, feature pack with Wi-Fi 6 on board and that kind of thing. Then we have the Trident Z Neos. These are very good RGB RAM. It's 3600 CL16. So not only do you have good frequency, you also have good latency as well. So this is what we're going to use. So the 3080 Super here, like I mentioned just now, is a placeholder for the theoretical 3080, 1TB SSD, 750W. Yep. For 3.2K, that's what you're going to be getting. Oh yes, let's add in the free RGB strip and the free white cables because I want my set to look colorful. So right, let's go along with that. And the disclaimer that I'm going to put here again is that this is theoretical. We do not know whether the price is going to be like this. I do not have a crystal ball in front of me. The price is not going to be exactly as what you see down here. Prices do go up and down. But yeah, this is probably the ballpark figure of what you're going to get for these price figures. So I'll leave it over to Mel to sum up the video.
All right, thank you, Gordon, for these two theoretical builds. So as mentioned, we are not so sure what's going to change and what's going to happen when we actually get these cards on hand. Right now in the comment sections below, what do you think of our two builds? Is there anything that we need to change, or what builds you will come out with for your own RTX 3080 or 3070 builds? So if you like this video, make sure to give us a thumbs up and make sure to check back to our channel, because we may or may not be able to get a hands on this card. So check back to our channel to see this card in action. So for Gordon and I, we say goodbye.